This is Science Quest. With your host, Jed Allen Frills. He's taking you around the world, discussing everything science.
Hi, I'm Jed Allen Frills, and thanks for joining me today on Science Quest. Today we're in Miami, Florida, in the Everglades, but we're not here for the reasons you might think. Today, I'd like Captain Wayne to tell you about how an airboat works. Now, it might not be the typical boat you have back at your lake. You know, the one that has a motor, and it goes down in it as a propeller that moves water. Airboats were completely different. They're still used to transport us across the water, but we're not using that prop on your typical motor. Captain Wayne, can you tell us about it?
Sure. Well, the airboats actually started in Utah, believe it or not.
In Utah?
In Utah. And a guy named Francis Taylor. The area we're in is actually Conservation Area 3A, 3B. And it's also nicknamed Francis B. Taylor.
Francis B. Taylor.
And I happen to know the man.
Okay.
And he was my father's Boy Scout leader, believe it or not.
I'll be darned. Francis B. Taylor, okay.
Yeah, they called him Franny.
Okay.
Well, Franny brought this inception he found out there. They were plywood hulls, made like a peanut shell.
Okay.
And they put an airplane motor on the back. So nothing stayed in the water. They just skimmed across. And they actually used them in the winters and the ice to move transport equipment from place to place, like construction sites and oil well drills in place, and they would move that stuff on the ice. Well, there's no motor in the water, so they didn't cut the ice. They slide across the top of it, just like we slide across the grass out here.
Only friction you have is right with the bottom of the boat.
And you actually have an airplane motor, but this one is a little bit bigger, newer model. It's a car motor, but it's adapted for use of an airboats. And then you have a great big propeller back here. It's basically the same thing as an airplane propeller. Back in the early 30s, they had pusher planes with the propellers in the back and then pullers with the propeller in the front. Well, this is a pusher plane.
So it has four blades.
It has four blades, and it pushes the air across these rudders back here, you see them? And the rudders, actually, that's your steering. If you go forward, it takes you to the right. If you go backwards, it takes you to the left. And you can slide across the top of the grass, not really hurting the grass or anything.
So we're controlling the airflow that's leaving the airboat.
Correct.
That's controlling where we go.
Right, but remember, we don't have brakes.
No brakes.
So you got to plan where you stop.
Got to be thinking ahead. Talk to me about horsepower. How many horsepower would this engine be developing?
Well, this engine is actually a pretty special motor. And it's actually developing 710 horsepower. It dynoed at that.
710 horsepower, so turning four blades.
Right, this one has a lot of propulsion. Most aircraft motors, like when they started them, were 100 horsepower, 90 horsepower, even some 65s. And then, of course, you know, over the years, you know, we always get bigger and better.
Right.
You know, everything's get bigger.
710 horsepower pushing us across the top of the Everglades. We're also not damaging the Everglades, though.
No, not at all. If anything, you'll see some trails on the camera and the footage. And those trails are made by airboats. But as soon as the water level comes back up, we're almost in our drought time of year. When the water level comes back up, those will just fill back in. And you'll actually lose your trail and get turned around.
Talk to me about speeds on airboat. Top speeds.
Well, there's some of them, not this one. But there's some of them, these guys that, you know, like, you know, the drag race guys. They want to drag race airboats.
Sure.
Speed is everything, these guys. Some of them are reaching 100 miles an hour in 600 feet.
100 miles an hour in 600 feet across
the
Everglades.
Very fast.
So thanks for telling us a little bit more about airboats today. It's been an amazing trip through the Everglades, and you couldn't get here in your normal boat. We'd be cleaning the prop out of grass a lot.
We'd be busy.
Thanks for joining us today on Science Quest.